Are you a teacher? If you are, I want to show you how you can use Perplexity AI for research. And we're going to take a look at this very important question right here. I'm going to show you how you can use Perplexity to quickly get solid answers that you can trust. Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. As a current teacher who's taught now for 25 years, this question is all around us. And if you're a teacher, you know what I mean. So let's use Perplexity right now to start and see where it gets us for answers. I'll put the link to perplexity.ai down below in the description. And just to let you know, I am using the pro version that I pay monthly, but you can test this out for free as well. So I'm already logged in to my account, and here's the question. And I'm going to go ahead and just ask it this question, and I'll show you the response that you'll get. Now, versus something else, if you're using Google, you know all the links that you have to go through when you're researching. But what Perplexity does for me, it's going to be pulling from all these different sites that it's curating, and it also gives me the links right to them. So as I look through the answer, this is a lot different than just going through, clicking on a site, reading it. It's giving this to me, and then it has all the citations, the links, where I can go to those specific pages. So look at the response here that it gives me in just that simple question, and I can dig further down into this by asking a follow-up. So what I'm really curious about, has it ever been this high? So I go ahead and ask it this question, has teacher burnout always been this high? So I'm going to go ahead and just ask it that. So within my search here, it will continue and give me more sources and give me more answers. And this is what I love. It's giving me the answers, saving me a lot of time. And it's like I'm having a discussion with it. When I get a different idea, I can go ahead and just ask it for more follow-up here. And as I'm going through this and I'm just skimming this right now, I'm getting more questions that I want to answer this, and especially with this COVID one. So now I'm going to go ahead and ask it further describe the impact of COVID-19 on teacher burnout. So let's go ahead and ask that. And as it goes through, you can see how my conversation is continuing, and it makes research just this much more easy. Again, with all the different links to all the sites, if I want to check out any of the sources where it's coming from. Look at the quality answers that you're getting as I scroll through here. What I really like about Perplexity AI is that all the information that it gathers through here needs to be sourced. It's not going to go ahead and create any filler or fluff that you can see happen in other AI programs. And the other thing is, if you get stuck and you don't know what to ask it anymore, it will give you suggestions down here. So related questions. So now as I follow through, I'm going to go ahead and click on this one. What are some of the potential long-term effects of teacher burnout? And then it can get my mind even thinking more if you're stuck with research. And then you can see how this can get your creativity working for you as well. I'm going to go and start a new thread because I really want to show you how you can use focus in Perplexity to get a better answer. So I'm just going to go and click on new thread up top here, and I'm going to ask this important question. How can educators prioritize self-care in their busy schedules in an effort to reduce teacher burnout? Notice we have the focus right here, and I'm going to come back to this. I want to show you, first of all, if we do it without any focus. And as it goes through, since I'm using the pro version here, I can actually pick different topics or different aspects to search, but I'm going to go and skip this, and we'll just keep this fairly general with that question. Now, when I look at the answer that it gives, when I don't give a focus, what you're going to notice is that it's a pretty generic answer. Not to say that it's bad, but it's pretty generic. Now, what I'm looking for is something a little bit more specific that I feel like I could get a better answer for. So let's go back, and this time we're going to go new thread, and I'm going to give it the same question. Take a look at the focus here. I'm going to click on it, and I can look in academic, writing, YouTube, and Wolfram here, Alpha. But what I'm really interested in is Reddit. Now, I think I can get some really good answers if it searches through Reddit. So I have my focus now. Let's go ahead and ask it. Again, I'm going to skip this here just for this demo Now, look at the answers you get here. In the first time I did this, as I said, it was pretty generic, but now using Reddit as a focus, it's given me actual plan of action here that I could use. And the list is detailed and a lot longer. So you do have different options when you use your focus, but definitely take advantage of it because your research is going to get a lot stronger. What I really enjoy about Perplexity AI is that it's a human-centric experience. The answers that I get are tailored towards me. So I go ahead and ask it a question, the follow-up questions, but then I can choose from the related questions that it gives me. And then I can go ahead and pick that focus to get even better answers. Now, if you're a teacher and you want to learn more about this, I do know Perplexity is putting together a course, and I'll put the link in my description so you can check that out to learn more about Perplexity and the great options that it has. But thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.